Hooray! So,
I have a fun fact.
What's that?
Do you know why you go back to the last bonfire you rested at with a bone?
I'm assuming it's because sitting down at the bonfire is what sets your spawn point.
No, like, lore-wise.
Oh. No, go ahead.
Look closely at that bonfire, friend.
I'm looking at the bonfire.
Maybe you have your binoculars.
I see a spooky skeleton in it.
Yeah, those bonfires are not kindled with wood, they are kindled with bones.
Yeah, they are.
So homeward bones are a piece of bone from a certain bonfire. And that's why it takes you back.
Intradasting.
Interblurbing.
Yeah. So, let's see. Is the Gold Tracer by itself better than the Fury Sword? Wow, by a very, very large margin. Yes, it is. Okay, well, I guess I'll be using that then. So, as I was about to say, having the Gold Tracer in your left hand gives you a really cool moveset, but also it's extremely dangerous because you can't also have a shield out while you're using it. So I'm just going to use it as a curved sword. I hope everybody's okay with that.
Swords.
Curved. Swords. Oh, that's much better. I guess the downside to the Gold Tracer is that it's got really crappy, it's got crappy range.
Well, yeah, but if you care, then you can wreck anything that comes near you.
That is true. That is very true. Whoops!
So this is where the stream's gonna be, huh?
I thought that would be solid ground, but I was wrong. It was not solid ground. Also, the Gold Tracer does bleeding, by the way. So, that's also cool. God.
You're a fucking idiot.
God damn it! Oh! I know the guy fell before I did, but I was stuck in a swing, okay? There was nothing I could do. My fate was sealed.
Oh, I'm so glad Artix isn't here to make fun of you.
Artix can go fuck himself! He can just hypothetically go fuck himself! That's right, Liquidy Poo is right. I just had to confirm that I got the guy. And, yeah, I got him alright, and then I got myself. You know, it's funny. I think these guys actually might have exactly 400 health. To the number. Which is good for...
Says, don't get got.
I already got. There was nothing I could do about it. Did you tweet about me?
No.
Okay, because I just got another phone message.
Is somebody else tweeting about you?
Probably. Boy, this is a real... This is a real shit show so far. I'm sorry this has gone so poorly so far. We just gotta, you know, just remember to breathe.
Can you kick with this moveset?
Nope. It does the flippy. Yeah, we have the flippy with this. Don't worry about it. Oh, but you can still do the cool secondary attack. You just can't do like the normal hit combo. Yes, damn you, curved swords. So Faye, what other lore we got for Ulysseal?
Another like massive mount, really. Without like, saving some stuff for when we get to Manus. But I mean, basically, you know what you said is entirely correct. The Abyss started bleeding out into everywhere else, and everything got messed up because that's what happens when you're exposed to the amount of humanity that's down there.
Yeah, and believe us, there is quite a bit of humanity down there, as you may see if I ever get there. Also, Marvelous Chester would be invading me right now if I was human, but fuck it, I'm almost out of humanity.
don't we need to, like, grind humanity for a little bit to feed it to the, feed it to the Fat Lady?
We do need to do that, but I would rather not do that on the stream. That seems like it'd be boring for a stream. I don't know.
I mean, so is talking about dicks for an hour and a half, so...
No, that's entertaining. That is comedy.
And us talking about Zeus and his love of being a swan.
God, why a swan? Did the person like swans, or did he just like, you're like, haha, swans are beautiful. They'll never see it coming when I put my swan penis in them.
I don't know.
I don't understand Zeus's logic. I don't understand any of the logic of this parable. I just don't get it.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what this is supposed to teach.
By the way, these guys hit really hard. I think I mentioned that already.
You demonstrated it, too.
I did. I demonstrated it with my body.
It's okay. You were just showing people how much damage they do.
That's right. This is a completionist stream. Let's play stream. Let's stream play. Let us stream play Dark Souls.
Man, can you imagine, like, Twitch plays Pokemon or something like that, but with Dark Souls?
They would win faster than me. Like, they would probably be done with the... They would be fighting Manus right now. They wouldn't have fallen off that cliff.
No, they probably would have.
Alright, well, maybe they would have several times, but they do it, like, fast. They do it in rapid succession. And so it'd turn out better. It'd go quicker overall for them. That's true. They just spend the whole time, like, writing messages. Like, they'd write they just spend time writing messages in front of Guinevere.
My favorite.
Be wary of swamp.
I'm an imminent tight spot is my favorite.
Be wary of bleeding.
Imminent holding
by the
both
way,
hands. What?
That's right. By the way, running out of humanity is actually not a problem really right now, because I am in an area that I have not beaten the boss in, and every time you kill, I think it's 10, approximately, give or take, 10 enemies, you will get a free soft humanity like I just did.
You,
so there you go,
you
I knocked a guy off,
humanity?
Are you happy now? What's that?
You call it soft humanity? What?
What is that doing here? I don't care, I'm wearing it.
What did you just... Okay. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna take that off now because it drains your health.
Like, you call it soft humanity? Because I call it liquid humanity. Like
soft humanity, liquid humanity.
Yeah, soft
you get
humanity
a number
sounds
in the
like
top
an
left.
Aesthetic.
What? So, you know, soft humanity. The, you know, you're like a human rights activist.
Yeah.
Aha! Fuck you, sorceress. Eat my shit. Eat 32 shits.
See, it's good, right?
It is pretty good. Liquidy Poo says he is obviously biased towards calling it liquid humanity, and I agree. I think it's better off that way. What's really annoying, I think, about the Ulysseal inhabitants is that you can't parry them, which is really annoying. Like, these guys would be so much easier to deal with if you could parry them, but you can't. Also, this, like, little major props to the developers of Dark Souls for their ability to, like, create enemy setups that will fuck you up. Like, this big open room is just genius. Like, it really is. Because, like, the enemies are properly configured so that if you run and hide, they'll chase you. But also, if you stand out in the open and fight them, you'll have to dodge a bunch. Like, their aggro radiuses are, like, perfectly configured so that they will, like... Ah! Not again! Okay, maybe again, fine.
But hey, you got a mimic hat.
That's true.
You are getting many fine hats this episode.
That's true. And it is true. Parrying them wouldn't, like, actually make me do more damage to them, really, because I kill them in two hits anyway. But what it would do is it would immobilize them. Like the main problem of fighting these guys as an enemy is that they're fucking fast. Like, they attack, like you saw that, like, those swipes. Like, if I was able to parry that, then he would stop doing it, and I wouldn't have to, like, you know, like, try and block an unblockable attack.
Would you say they gotta go fast?
They've gotta go fast! Gotta go fast!
Gotta go faster, 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 faster.
That's right. Dongalore, I'm wearing the sack instead of my mask because it is shame. I am full of shame for the events of this stream so far.
Oh, is this the Don's hat?
Yes, the sack is the shame hat.
I do not like the cone of shame.
I wish there was a cone of shame hat.
Modders. Like, if modders can add realistic horse anuses into Skyrim, they can add a dunce hat into Dark Souls.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say they could add horse anuses into Dark Souls, and it's like, I mean, I guess they could. There is a horse message.
Yeah, why? There's no horses in the game. Black Yoshi says, I often go through whole playthroughs with either the sack or egghead, and I approve of egghead.
Yes, I approve of the egghead, too. If it didn't take so long to get the egghead, I would go get the egghead just for you, Faye.
Stream chat doesn't know why we find eggs just so hilarious.
I think you explained it. I've explained it
several times in various, like, when we've been playing various different games. But I don't think this stream chat understands why I find eggs so funny.
I guess that's true. And I mean, you can backstab the inhabitants. You just can't parry them. And I wish you could, because it'd make them stop. And, like, funneling them into this little hallway seems to be, like, good if you don't give them any ground, which is what I did before.
So it has a Sonic X theme in my head.
Please don't play it. I'll have to edit it out again.
No, you won't.
You're considering it.
You won't, though, because it'll show up on my audio.
You know what? That's true. That's very true.
Voice meter.
The power of voice meter is strong.
Guys, voice meter is such a good program for annoying your friends by, like, randomly piping the Digimon theme into conversations.
Also, these guys' corpses are, like, even crazier than normal Dark Souls corpses.
I guess maybe it's Dongalore
says, please don't. Yes, they're big, rotating bulbous heads, like, make them, like, fly all over the place.
I'm just having a big old corpse party up in here.
Oh no, not corpse party, oh no! Alright, so this is tricky.
That's your Homestuck reference for today.
Thank you. It's like Run-DMC says, it's tricky. So we're not going to fuck with that part of the room. That's progress over there, but there's like two sorcerers and like 10 bajillion inhabitants. I'm not fucking with that. I'm not down for that, man.
I'm not into that.
I'm not into that. That's not my fetish. So, I don't remember how to get over here to this chest. I think you actually straight up just have to jump this beam.
Also, I just nearly stabbed myself in the eye with a pen. I'm really intelligent.
Nice.
Is this just a random castle or Ulysseal apartments?
Hooah! Yeah!
Black Yoshi says you can't jump this beam as you jumped it.
I can jump this beam. Rawr! It's a tight night chunk.
Are you okay, friend?
But also... Oh, no. That's just the video that I assume he was referencing.
Oh.
So, wait. If I can't jump the beam, how else do I get into this room? What is in this room?
Dongalos says, take off the sack, you've earned it.
I will take off the sack.
How did you fit through that door?
With a roll, a very well-timed roll. No, well, I didn't make it back across, but whatever.
Put the dunce hat back on.
No, I like this. I'm keeping it.
Okay. There's a light door around here somewhere. I think that's what you're supposed to do.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I actually don't remember where to get the pendant from. I know it's... I think it's in this place somewhere. Isn't it? Faye, do you remember where you get the silver pendant?
No, but the internet does.
Yes, ask the internet. The internet has all the answers.
Siri. This is funny because I have an Android. I'm not asking Siri or the Android equivalent.
What is it? I don't remember what the name is, but I know that the Microsoft one is Cortana, which is really funny to me.
Also, guys, I recently made C. Jacobs discover emoji on his phone.
Yes! Oh, man.
We've just been sending each other bugs for the past few days.
Hell yeah.
After the first bloated sorcerer, turn right and keep going down the path until you see a wooden ledge below with a corb.
Oh.
Roll down onto it, follow the ledge around the tower and drop down, follow this ledge and you'll come across a message saying, let there be light.
So there was a thing there. I thought that meant that you had to use the pendant there.
Cast light, the skull lantern, or use the sunlight maggot to remove the invisible wall.
Oh, that's right. I need a source of light. You can use the skull lantern, can't you?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Oh, did you just say that and I misheard
it?
Yeah,
I literally just said that.
Sorry, my brain didn't parse what you said just then.
That's okay. Yeah, you can either use the spell cast light, the skull lantern, or the sunlight maggot.
Okay, well, when I pass by there next, I will make sure to do that. Because we want that pendant.
Yes, we do.
Fuck it. Ow, fuck you. Fuck you!
How many dicks are we up to?
None, I didn't die. We're good. No, fuck your poison. So, these sorcerers just have an amazing repertoire of ways to dick you over. Like, if you get close, they cast poison, if you're far away, they cast dark orb, and if you're at a medium range, they cast dark bead. It's just, like, why? Why?
Also,
they're such assholes.
One touch that I really, really like about Ulusiel is all this blue abyss stuff hanging out. The further down you go, the more you can tell that the abyss is encroaching.
Yeah, the further you go down, the more corrupted it gets. And if you look, you can see... Yes, let us look through the Xanthus crown. You can see that there's like a gross, like, icky sludge. Like, it's not just like a pit. Like, there's like a gross, like, oily... water down there.
Gross.
And I'm assuming that's just like straight up like liquid, like
99% true. It's liquid, it's humanity.
It's literal liquid humanity. It looks like tar, kinda. Yeah, it does. Okay, I'm gonna take this off now. And I'm gonna put on. What am I gonna put on? Let's just put on the face mask.
Sorry, I got super confused. I was like, wait, why am I on a delay? It's like, because I'm looking at the stream, not the screen share.
Yeah, don't. You have the power. The power to observe.
What about the Crown of Dusk?
Doesn't the Crown of Dusk, like, reduce your HP for, like...
I'm not sure. Wear the pretty princess crown.
We'll see.
We are the prettiest princess. Patchouli is very pretty.
Its wearer is blessed by all manner of magic. This raises the power and effect of the wearer's magic, but damage suffered by magic attacks also rises. Nope, fuck that. I am not wearing that here.
Yeah, maybe somewhere where sorcerers aren't constantly trying to kill us.
Oh, the ring. The ring is the one that reduces the HP. I'll wear it later. I won't wear it now, but I will put it on because people want me to.
What other silly hats do we have?
Well, we have the symbol of avarice, but it drains your health.
That's a very,
I wish it didn't.
It's a very silly hat.
I wish it didn't, because it's like, it's so beautiful.
Oh yeah, we have the pig hat.
We do have the pig hat, but I don't know if I can fast roll with it. We'll see. Yep, we're good. I'm wearing the pig hat.
Okay.
And now that I can be human, I'm gonna go over to where Chester invades you, because I think it can still happen even though I pass by the area. It happens over by the mimic, doesn't it?
I think so. Black Yoshi says fast pig. Gotta pick fast. The barbarian. Okay, sure.
I am destined to not fight Chester. I just... It's like... There's like... In the annals of history, there was a large tome written in a deep, dark cave somewhere far underground in the reaches of Eastern Asia and the mountains somewhere. And in this dark cave, a blind man wrote about the fate of the undead and Dark Souls' story and how one day the game will be played by a man named C. Jacobs. And he will play this game and he will never ever be able to show off Marvelous Chester's Invasion.
I think it was cursed.
God. I went too fast. I was the fastest pig. And it cost me. This is what happens when you are fast pig. Living life on the edge. But on the bright side, I got the bloated head, so I can put that on instead of the pig hat now.
Excellent.
I'm actually very glad that I got that, because I love the way it looks.
Let me go full screen so I can get a better view of it. Oh, yeah.
And I have
That's
to wonder...
That's my fetish.
And I have to wonder if it makes your head bloated, or if you just straight up took off some other undead's bloated head and put it over top of your own head.
I mean, either way, it's horrifying.
Oh yeah, definitely, which is why I love wearing it.
See, Jacobs, would you like a Jaffa cake?
God, I would love a Jaffa cake, but I have no way to receive it from you.
Oh, read the item description, it's really good. Read the description.
I will, hang on. I'm a little busy. This little corridor, this open courtyard right here, is like the hardest part of the township. And I'm really glad that they made a shortcut right before it, because there are two sorcerers here that fire on alternating firing patterns, and they have the high ground. Because of course they do.
Description.
I am a little busy.
It's not so bad.
I died. I was trying to roll, but I held the button down for like...
I told you. It's not so bad.
A little bit too long.
I actually now have a second line on my death count.
Wow. Oh, are you doing tally marks?
Yeah.
In school?
Yep.
So, the head of an Ulasteel resident whose humanity went wild after being devoured by the dark... Wow, that's weird translation. By the dark of Manus, father of the abyss. The bloated head is fissured, the cracks lined with innumerable tiny red eyeballs. With a hard outside and mucus-filled inside, no sane person could ever wear it. And yet, here we are. The part about the mucus-lined inside just is like... Ugh.
62 deaths, by the way.
Jesus Christ, I've died quite a bit in Ulasteel.
I mean, if it makes you feel any better, I died this amount of times getting to the gargoyles.
Jeez.
I'm really bad at Dark Souls.
That's fine.
The item description for rubbish also suggests that something is wrong with you.
I think I'm actually carrying around two rubbishes now. Now that I picked up the one in Ulasteel.
The item description for Flash Sweat mentions that people will look at you funny if you use it.
Yeah. Well, not completely insane, just mostly.
Yeah, the hollows are insane. Undead are not.
Yeah. Mostly.
Solaire is not hollow, but he's pretty insane.
He's pretty great. Shine, no, he's not insane yet.
Shine on,
we're not
you
at
crazy
that point
diamond.
Yet. Shine, literally shine. Literally shine on. Alright, so probably the... I don't know. I don't even know what is and isn't easy in this segment. Probably the easiest way to deal with these guys is to pull them all at once and then go back here. Not this far back, though, because that guy also aggroes. God! God! Damn it!
Friend, do you need, like, do you need a cookie or something?
I don't know what's happening.
Maybe.
I'm gonna have to do editing on this part. I don't want to do editing on this part.
You know what? You know what? Crack open that beer, friend. It might help.
Yeah, I guess I'll go do it.
Okay.
I'm gonna go get beer.
Let's. I can talk. So it's Drunk Souls time. I guess. So I'm just having really awkward conversations with the stream chat now. Hi, chat. How are you? How's everybody doing today? You enjoying yourself? There's just some guy screaming in the background. That's good. It's good. The true Booth Souls was inside you all along. Hello. Patchouli was just standing there and one of the residents...
Okay.
Hi. Patchouli was just standing there and one of the residents just screamed randomly in the background. It was quite good.
That's fine. Okay. So, maybe this will calm my nerves a little bit.
You're not drinking PBR again, are you?
Let's just continue.
Oh.
It's fine. It's cheap.
This relationship is over.
Oh no, Faye, why? It's all I have in the fridge, I think, actually.
I thought you meant like the relationships, like wait, is that why you keep them?
Yes, the relationship that we have is all I have in the fridge. Ow! God damn it! God damn it! I'm going back to the bonfire. We're gonna try this again.
Okay. So how is your shitty beer for plebs?
It's fine. It could be worse, I guess. It could always be worse.
You know what?
I could not have one
at
all.
You know what? Just to spite you, I'm gonna buy some strawberry and lime cider and drink it on stream.
That sounds really good.
It's so good.
I went out there and my grandparents are actually just down the hallway, actually. They can probably hear me talking about them right now.
Hi, Grandma.
They're cleaning the turtle's tank. You remember the turtle, right? My neighbor.
I do remember the turtle.
Yeah, they're in my bathroom right now, cleaning the turtle's tank. So yeah, I probably shouldn't say anything incredibly dirty about penises or whatever. Yeah, I got another bloated head. Now I can have two. Great.
Just like put one on each hand and do a puppet show.
Do a puppet show about how sad I am, about how I keep failing.
Do a puppet show like The Abyss and Ula Seal.
That's right.
Use
so the other
boxing gloves.
The other method for pulling these guys is to I sent the lift back up and I forgot, so now I'm dead. I'm just dead now. Oh, there we go. Well, basically, the general strategy that I usually employ is to pull these guys, and then one of the guys doesn't follow you through the door for whatever reason, so then you only have to fight two of them at a time instead of three.
How do you type with bloated heads on?
And then one of the sorcerers comes down from the steps because fuck you, that's why. By which I mean, fuck me, not you, Faye. It's kind of hard to fuck your girlfriend through the internet.
It's true.
We would know a lot about that, right?
Yeah. Long-distance relationship problems, huh?
Can I talk about that now that our internet relationship is over?
Yeah, sure. Sorry, maybe one person in chat understands this joke, and they probably don't find it nearly as funny as I do.
No, you and I are probably the only people who find that actually funny. But it doesn't matter.
To clarify, no, we are not dating. I am a homosexual.
No. Yeah. Oh, I hate this guy. What is even this guy's point? I don't understand this man. What is the lore of the chained prisoner? Does he even have any?
I don't think so.
He's got so much health, and physical attacks bounce off of him, and he's just a nightmare, and I don't know why I'm even fighting him.
Let me look it up. I don't think there's anything, I don't know a great deal about the DLC, I must admit.
I hardly ever play the DLC because it's such fucking bullshit. Oh my god, it's such bullshit. But it's fun bullshit. It's just that casual play doesn't lend itself well to bullshit. Oh, he's gonna follow me, isn't he? God, I hate this guy. This guy is basically a more agile version of the Iron Boar. That's basically how you have to fight this guy. He drops the chainmail set. I think that's all that he drops. Damn it.
Oh yeah, he's covered in chains.
Oh well, yeah, but it's a really weird thing for him to drop. Ow. God. Everything does so much damage in the DLC. Everything. Yeah, I know, what a prize.
Yeah, there's not a great deal involved with these guys.
He's just a dude that's covered in chainmail and iron and stuff for no reason.
I found a YouTube video, let's watch Dark Souls Lore by Dark Urban Souls.
No, don't do it, don't watch it. Because we're about to enter the abyss.